The purpose of this video is to provide a brief overview of Oxygen's design mode for JSON schema documents. For this demonstration, let's suppose I have a JSON-based product catalog and I want to have a product ID, name, price, and some optional tags. The first thing I'll do is to create a JSON schema from scratch. Notice that there's a JSON schema template in the file creation wizard. And the newly created file is opened directly in the design mode. So I'll start designing my schema, and the first property that I want to define is the product ID. And I want to set the identifier type to be an integer. The description of the property is presented at the bottom of the property. To change it, I can double click on it, or I can right click and use the Edit Annotations action. All of the annotations of a JSON schema component can be edited in this dialog box. I'll change the value of the description. I want my product ID property to be set as required, so I'll right click on the schema root and I'll use the Edit Properties action and I'll set product ID as the value of the schema's required property. Next, I'll define the product name property. And I want to set its type to string, but it's not displayed, so I'll need to add it. For this, I could right-click and use the Edit Properties action, or I can go to Options, and I'll find the Type property and uncheck the option called Only If Specified. This means that it'll be displayed in the diagram even if it does not have a value. Now it's displayed, so I'll set the value to string. Now I'll use the Edit Annotations action to set the value of its description. And I want to also set it as a required property. Next, I'll define the price property. And I want its type to be number, but I'll intentionally misspell it. Notice that the validation engine automatically reports such issues. I can hover over the error to see a tooltip with more details. And the error is also reported in the vertical range ruler on the right side and also in the results pane at the bottom of the editor. So I'll fix the typo. Then I'll use the exclusive minimum property to specify that the value of the price must be something other than zero. I also want it to be a required property, so I'll add it. Next, I'll add the tags property. And I want to have multiple tags for each product, so I'll set the type to array. Then I'll add an items definition. And I want the type for each tag to be a string. And I'll set the unique items value to true and the min items value to 1. So the JSON schema is created, and you can switch to text mode to see how the source JSON schema looks like. And the two modes are synchronized, so any modification made in one mode is presented in the other. You can also visualize and edit complex JSON schemas in design mode. I have a pretty complex schema here, and I'll expand some of the definitions. Note that if the schema contains references to definitions from another file, you can click the Go to Definition icon to open the corresponding file. As a side note or tip, you can use the keyboard instead of the mouse to navigate through the diagram. I can even print or save a diagram as an image. And this is what the exported image looks like in a photo app. The schema diagrams can also be included in generated schema documentation. I'll use the Generate Schema Documentation button from the toolbar. And in this dialog box, I'll expand the Included Components Details section. And I want to make sure the diagram option is selected. And I'll also enable this option to split the output into multiple files. And I'll generate it. And now you can see that there is also a diagram for each component in the generated documentation. This helps to more easily visualize and understand the schema. This concludes the demonstration of the JSON schema design mode. And as always, thank you for watching.